Once again, I made a goof. The audio on my microphone was quiet because the audio level was really low. Like, really low. Most of the time, you'll be hearing the game instead of my voice, unless I scream out loud out of rage. Hope you enjoy it. And my suffering! This is awkward. You're never gonna believe what happened while I was trying to play this game and record it. Well, I was playing with my brother. Twice. Beat this the rest of this world, and then went on to the next aisle. Guess what happened? The first episode, we defeated this inkwell aisle, the second aisle. We, had some problems with the lag. Not the gameplay itself, but rather the video. And on the third world, we were just arguing, and it was terrible. So, I wanted to replay everything. And it's been a ride, let me tell you. So, before I officially give you the intro, let me tell you what happened so far. I talked to the little girl, we earned a coin from her. We defeated the dragon, and we defeated the funhouse fillet thing. We defeated two bosses in the next aisle. And while I was trying to fix it and failing, I watched Jacksepticeye play some episodes of this and discovered that there's actually a coin hidden here. Should be somewhere over here, I'm not sure. Yeah, right there. There's a coin right there. And also, you remember that barbershop quartet, the fourth guy that was missing? He's out in one of the levels. Herb the Derp. But turns out, he's over here! At last! I thought I'd never see another living soul again! I lost my way while searching for coins. No one has money for haircuts these days, thanks to that plastic casino. Well, I'd better get back to my pals in the quarantine. Yep, that's where he is. And I wonder what happens when he talks to him. Aw, I'm so happy. Oh boy, you did it! We're a quartet once more. Gee, you must run yourself ragged tracking him down. We can't thank you enough. Let's celebrate the song. Lady boys, key of B-flat.
It's nice to rest your eyes and maybe go outside. Grab a book and get some air. So what are you waiting for?
Bum, 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 bum.
Why not take a quick break? Tune the radio.
There's
chores to do, there's leaves to rake. From the old banjo, you can practice your Lindy.
Oops, I skipped the song while I was just making sure I was recording. This game's judging my life decision. What's up, Docs? I'm the Billboy. Welcome back to Cuphead and Don't Deal with the Devil. As you saw earlier, we got the Barbershop Quartet, and we're going to be replaying some levels that I wasn't supposed to play, but kind of did because I thought it would be good, but it turned out to be wrong, so we're going to do Funhouse Finanzel. This level is
now go.
A pain in the rectum, let me tell you. It has this card thing where it flips your gravity around in the funhouse, and there's this really bad delay between actually going on up to the ceiling or floor and hitting the car. It is a pain in the butt, but hey, what can you do? It causes a lot of damage to be taken. Well, not really unfairly, but it takes a lot to while you get used to. This took forever to get through. Me and my brother. As I mentioned, me and my brother tried to play this together. It didn't go so well. Get up there. Try not to get hit by star cannons. Sounds like something from Kirby! Oh god. One health is stressful. You're back. back in your box. Nobody likes you out of your box. Oh, and this guy? Let's just go back. Now, this guy. Holy crap, this guy. There are some enemies with some really bullcrap attacks, but that guy took the cake in my book. No, don't kill me! No! One second. I'm trying to get to that guy is one thing, but trying to avoid his attacks while having to deal with the delay of going up and down on the ceiling, on the floor. It's not that fun, I tell you. Oh, God. Yeah, you see? Look at that! Did you see that? You saw that, right? Look how close I was. That's...
You're up!
No! Stupid delay! Ah! Still got hit anyways. Finally. Oh, here's this guy again. No! Look how close I was.
Now,
such a pain in the butt. Get back in your box! Woo! Not today. Oh God, what is this, Kiss? Funhouse Edition? Bravo! Thank you, Scratching an Itch. That was easy. Well, it took me like 2 minutes, it'll be fine. I still got all the points, but... What?! Why was that 2 stars? That was amazing. Now, where were we? Grip Matchstick and Fury Frolic. Yeah. Apparently people have been telling horror stories about this dragon. This boss, specifically. But personally, I don't see it as a big deal. Me personally, I mean, fuck. Yeah, I mean, that just proves my point. I was trying to parry and I failed. There we go. I mean, it's a pain to have to go through clouds, but honestly, once you get used to his attack pattern, it's not really that big of a deal. Honestly, it can get pretty easy. Glad I have this. Otherwise. Because the final phase is. It's kind of hard to not get hit in that at least once. So to have all five cards along with the second super R. Why did I say fifth super R? There's only like 3. As far as I'm concerned. Yeah, because me and my brother were playing this, we thought we had to hit the head. Turns out you can literally just hit the body and I die. Let's try that again. Damn it. Trying to parry and failing out at the same damn time. Holy pain. The only thing you have to deal with from this thing is the fireballs that jump from his tongue. And it can be really hard to... Ow! Really hard to avoid these pieces of crap. But once you do, it gets kind of easy, I guess. I think I had to smoke bomb. Here we go. But meet the Hydra, everybody! Yeah. to be excited about this part of the fight is, you gotta see these bubbles right that he shoots. You have to not shoot them, otherwise they'll shoot horizontally and vertically. Ah! I'd say unless you're on the really high clouds, there's no reason to hit him in the head. Wrong button! Why do I keep pressing the wrong buttons? I meant to use the special, but I accidentally started dodging. Whoa! Ah! Halfway through the final phase. We got this. Well, did you see those sweet moves? Can't hit me, I'm the gingerbread kid. Or the cuphead man. Woo! Ow, come on! How do you like me now? Because I had to play this fight several times, not to beat it, but to just... Because remember how I said the first time I tried to play this with my little brother in the beginning, how it was laggy, but it didn't really make sense because I didn't really make full sentences, and it just was all over the place because I wanted to get over the video over with. Well, this fight in particular is what was lagging. The video, not like the gameplay itself, but like every time I got to this phase onwards, it would skip frames, like constantly. It was just janky and it was terrible, and I just and this is the fight I was used to testing, like all the settings and stuff I was tinkering with. Eventually, my friend Josh helped me, and everything seems to work now. I hope so, at least. It better not change by the time I finish this, but whatever. From what I remember, it seems to be doing fine. Ow! You know what? For this next round, total silence. Starting now. We did it, everybody. And now... we got a B. My best was an A- because of how many times I tested the footage on the dragon. Because that's the one that lagged the most. So I figured, fuck it. Next, we're going to Inkwell Isle 3. And I'm going to show you what the transition between this island and the next island. Oh, wait. Little mugs have some fight in them. I'll say that much. They're making mincemeat out of the debtors. You see, I knew there was something special about those fellas. Well, don't be too sure just yet, boss. I think there's something fishy about those two. Don't blow your wig, Dice. If those two little things try anything, I'll be waiting. Yep. This is the boss I fought first. And that's the boss we fought next. Then we tried to play this level and it was terrible. Because we just kept arguing. Though, on the plus side, once we beat this level, we can go to the next shop and get some more weapons. First, let me talk to these two NPCs.
Arr! You're gonna need some tips if you want to keyhaul these deadbeats. Start by mixing up your weaponry. Can't expect all your arms to work on the same every foot fuck. Mix and match, landlubbers. That's what I say.
I thought I was gonna read that perfectly, but then I screwed up on that one part. Next, the turtle.
You boys think this situation is a multicolored mess, don't you?
But what if I told you there was a way to see it in shades of gray?
A way that only a pacifist platform would be able to perceive.
Would you violent little mugs believe me if I told you that?
I wonder.
I don't know, but speaking of which, before I play either of these two bosses, I'm going to play Perilous Piers, because I need to get some coins, desperately.
Now, go!
Flying fish, haha.
Those butterflies look like the ones from Kirby.
You remember those things? They kind of look like, anemones, and they would shoot projectiles at Kirby. Yeah. Anyways, the reason why I'm playing this level instead of first instead of all the other bosses that we beat first is because, well, I need a lot more weapons for those boss fights, because with the weapons I have at my disposal right now, aside from the Seeker, these bosses are going to be pain in the rectum to beat. I mean, the Seeker's good and all, but I think the only fight it would be good against is the pirate ship boss. Because for half the fight, you have to aim at the pirates, and then you have to, well, I won't spoil it. I forgot about the lobster. Screw this lobster to hell and back. Yeah. This is where we got lost. Oh, you're back? Not for long. Here's the next final coin, I think. Okay, this is where we had the most trouble on, because it's like an octopus mini boss, and all we have to land on top of the friggin' thing. So we thought this was like a mini boss, like the octopus itself, but it turns out you can just land on its head and ride him. Oh, look how close I was. Come on. I know this is a type of shrimp that can, a lobster that can shoot stuff from its claws. Not like shoot it, but like create something that. Never mind. It's biologically a lobster that's similar to this one. That's what I'm trying to say. Wait, oh, I see. I don't see. Ow! Fuck. I don't see why these guys have such a bone to pick with Cuphead. You're a bug. Also, is there a way I can avoid this oyster? Nope, apparently not. No! I didn't see the boulder. I still don't have to. God damn it. soon as I finish this level, I'm going back to Buffet Cake and eat every single oyster mussel there is! No! Oh, where am I? 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 Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god! Ah! Oh, come on! I didn't know where I was! Relapser! Ah, lightning! Does it help me? Is there gonna be an oyster that appears? Yes, 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 yes! Yes! Grind, save me. Amen. I need. What do I need? Roundabout. At least stone.
Goodbye.
That's all I need. Thank y'all. Thank you all so much for watching. Not everyone earns a grade A rating, if you know what I mean. And not everyone can maintain that level of quality over time. Consistency, my dear friends, that is what it's all about. Then you will experience the scintillating sensations that I do. Whatever the heck you mean, man. God, that was infuriating. Just to get a few coins. And it took me like several hundred tries just because of that one octopus area. It was shit. Ach, that Wolfgang. Always taking 10 notes to express 2 notes worth of music. He has no conception of what I mean by less is more. I know you agree with me. Go convince that 10-year clock that he won't listen to it anymore. Thank you so much for watching this episode. I hope you all enjoyed my pain and suffering. And on the next episode, we will complete these 2 bosses. The Honey one, the Bee one, and the Pirate Ship one. But until then, thank you. down below. And I'll see the next episode of Whatever the Heck I Make. Ciao!